Welcome friends, in this video I will show you how to install Chromium OS on any laptop or PC.
Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel howisolve.com.
This is Neil. Before we start this tutorial, let us first take a look at what you can expect from Chromium OS. Chromium OS is the open source version of Google's Chrome OS, which has been specifically designed keeping in mind a specific hardware configuration, that is the Chromebook. Due to this reason, the hardware support for Chromium OS is not that developed. The specific build of Chromium OS that we will be installing has been made available thanks to Arnold the Bat. We will be using this build, which has additional hardware support than what is currently available in vanilla Chromium OS. But even then, one might face a lot of bugs due to the incompatible drivers. You can open a bug report at the GitHub project, the links of which is provided in the video description. This will ensure that the future builds will support your hardware. Having said that, I would advise you to first try running Chromium OS as a live operating system from a pen drive. If you are satisfied with the performance, then you can install it on your system. In this tutorial, I will show you how to make this live USB Chromium OS pen drive and then how to use that for installing it. So, let's start. The prerequisites for this guide are, you will require a system with at least 2GB RAM, a spare hard disk or solid state drive, which you can completely erase, since the installation will require it to be erased completely. Also, your system should have wireless LAN support, since Chromium OS depends on that. Also, for the installation, you'll require an 8GB pen drive. Also, you'll have to download the Chromium OS special build from Arnold, the links for which are provided in the video description down. And you'll require two softwares for making the installation pen drive, that is 7-Zip and Win32 Image Writer. The links for these two softwares are also provided down in the video description, which you can see by clicking on the View More button. This is the 7-Zip download website. Depending on your system architecture, either 32-bit or 64-bit, select the proper download link. Since my system is 64-bit, I will select this download link over here, download.exe, 64-bit x64, this one. This is the site for downloading Image Writer. To get the download link from this site, click on this link over here, External Downloads. Then the download should automatically start. Yeah, it started downloading. Then the next thing that we'll require to download is our Chromium OS special image provided by Arnold the Bat. So for that, we'll open that website, that is chromium.arnoldthebat.co.uk. Okay. On this side, you'll see three directories, that is daily, special, and weekly. Click on the special directory over here. Under this, you'll find several versions of Chromium OS. What we are interested in is in the latest special build release of Chromium OS. So to get that, first we'll order this list by last modified. To tap, click on last modified. Again, click on last modified. Okay, so the latest version available is CAMD64OS.0.special.7zip file. This also has got two versions. Depending on your system architecture, select either 64-bit or an x86-bit. Since my system is 64-bit, I will select this file over here. At the time of recording this video, the latest version of special build was released on October 30th, 2016. Okay, once we have got all these utilities downloaded, we'll install them respectively. The 7-zip and Win32 installation process is simple, so I'll skip that process and will straight away go to creation of installation medium. So first I will go to my downloads folder. This is the file that I have downloaded. To extract it, right click on it and select 7-zip and then click on extract here. After extraction, you will get a file of 7.5 gigabit size. It would be named as chromium os underscore image.img, this file over here. After extracting it, insert your pen drive into your system and open the Win32 image software. Here, this is the software, Win32 disk imager. Okay, in this it will ask for the image file, so we'll open that file, click on this icon over here to browse for that file. go to the downloads folder or wherever you have saved that extracted image file at 7.14 GB file. So I had saved it in downloads compressed over here. This is the file. I'll select that. Go to that software in 32 disk imager. And then select your device under here. Be very careful at this stage to select the proper device. Otherwise, you might erase your hard disk. Make sure that I am selecting my pen drive. I'll just check it in my computer here. This is my pen drive, that is the J drive. So I'll go in the software and select J drive. Make sure that you don't have any files that you would like to back up before continuing this process, because after this, the entire pen drive would be erased and you won't be able to recover any files from it. So after selecting a proper device and after making sure that you have got all the backups for the data present on your pen drive, click on write. This process will take around 10 to 15 minutes depending on your pen drive speed and your USB port. After this process is finished, you should get a properly bootable Chromium OS on your pen drive. So once this process is finished, you can remove the pen drive and load it on the system on which you want to install Chromium OS. So we will do that right now. I will install Chromium OS on my old Dell N5010 laptop. So I'll insert my USB drive in it, and then I have to boot it via the USB drive. For that, depending on your machine, you'll either have to change your BIOS settings and set a higher priority to your USB drive in the BIOS setup, or you might choose it from a boot menu to select a pen drive as your boot medium. I will show you how to change it in the BIOS on my laptop. So for that, you have to enter the BIOS setup. This also depends on your computer, and you can Google search it for which key your model allows you to enter the BIOS setup. In this Dell laptop, I have to press the F2 key to enter the BIOS setup. So I'll do that right now. Okay, now I'm in the BIOS setup. To change the boot medium preference, I'll go to the boot setup and set the first boot priority to my USB drive. As you can see from my current settings, it is set at USB storage device itself. Because this laptop actually doesn't have a hard disk, I usually use Puppy Linux on this via USB drive. That's why it's already been set properly and no changes is required in my system. Now I'll let it boot into Chromium OS. So I'll just restart it. It will load Chromium OS, and as you can see, Chromium OS logo is being shown and it is loading. Now depending on your system hardware, it is possible that you might not see this boot logo. In that case, there is some compatibility issue with your graphic card and the Chromium OS drivers. So you'll have to report this bug on the bug report page that I had discussed previously. Okay, anyway, so in my case, it boots properly into the boot screen. And as you can see, I've already set up my account. In your case, it will show you a welcome screen and ask you to set it up. You'll require to configure your Wi-Fi connection. After doing that, you can log into your account and check whether the Chromium OS is supporting all your hardware. If not, then again, you will have to either report it on the GitHub page, or you might have to tweak the hardware drivers if you know to do it. But anyway, after validating that the Chromium OS is running properly on your system, we'll continue with the installation process, that is to install it on your hard disk. So for doing that, press Ctrl+Alt+F2. You can press this button anytime after the Chromium OS has loaded. So I'll press it now. Ctrl+Alt+F2. Okay. Now you will be brought to this developer console where you will have to log in using your default login. The default username is CronOS. CHRONOS. So I'll log in using CronOS as my username. CHRONOS. Hit enter and no password should be asked. After you come to this prompt, type in lsblk. lsblk. Hit enter. What this command will do is it will list down all the disk drives and the respective sizes that are currently connected to your system. As you can see, in my case, there are basically three disk types it has identified, that is SDA, an SR0 and loop 0. SDA is my pen drive, and since the system doesn't have any hard drive, so there is no other drive mentioned. SR0 and loop 0 are part of the system memory itself. So in your system, find out the code for your hard disk or solid state drive. It might be SDA or SDB depending on your system configuration. After you identify that disk code, type this command followed by a hard disk code. In my case, I will just, for dummy purpose, I will just select the pen drive itself. It will not allow me to install, but just for demonstration purpose, I'll show you what happens. So I'll select SDA. Before you hit enter, I would like to warn you that after this command, all the contents on this particular disk drive that you have mentioned here will get erased. So make sure that you have got proper backup, or there's no data that you require from this particular disk drive. Okay, having said that, I'll just hit enter. Okay, now as you can see, it started to check whether the image that's on the pen drive is correct or not. But it has also mentioned that this disk drive is the same as from which it has booted. So in the end, it won't succeed. But I'm showing you this process for demonstration purpose. In your case, that warning would not be shown. Okay, after this installation is finished, it might take around 15 to 20 or 1 hour also. It all depends on the system configuration. If you are using SSD, it would be quite quick. If it's a hard disk, then it might take a long time. After this installation is finished, you can set up your Google account, and then I'll show you how to update this system. Okay, after you have completed the installation, log in into your account. I'll log in as guest. Okay, the Chrome browser will open up. So to update this Chrome OS, what you have to do is go into the settings, click on this three dots icon over here, and click on settings, and under here click on about Chrome OS over here, and here click on this button, check for an apply update. So as soon as Arnold the Bat releases an update, you'll get the latest version of Chromium OS on your system. I hope this guide helped you. If yes, smack that like button below. If you are facing some problem following this guide, share it below in the comment section. You can help others by sharing this guide to your friends whom you think could benefit from it. At howisolve.com, we provide you with the latest updates on technology, tutorials, tips and tricks, troubleshooting guides, and much more. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get regular updates. Thanks for watching, friends. See you later. Bye.